Welcome to a division problem involving mixed numbers. Here we have 3 1/2 divided by 2 1/3. So our goal here is to determine how many 2 1/3 there are in 3 1/2. To do this, we'll first find the quotient using an alternative method where if we have the fractions with a common denominator, we can find the quotient by determining the quotient of the numerators. Notice here if we have a over b divided by c over b, this is equal to a over c, or a divided by c. The reason this works is because if we have a common denominator, all the pieces are the same size, and therefore we have a pieces divided by c pieces, which would just be a divided by c. And we'll also find the quotient using the traditional method, where instead of dividing, we multiply by the reciprocal. But the first thing we need to recognize is that we have to write the mixed numbers as improper fractions. So let's start there. For 3 1/2, the denominator is going to stay 2, and then for the numerator we would have 2 times 3 plus 1, which is 7. So 3 1/2 is equivalent to 7/2, and then divided by, for the second fraction the denominator stays 3, and for the numerator we would have 3 times 2 plus 1, which is also 7. So now for the alternative method, we want to start by obtaining a common denominator, which would be the least common multiple of 2 and 3. And since 6 is the least common multiple of 2 and 3, we want both denominators to be 6. So for 7/2, we'll multiply by 3 over 3 to obtain a denominator of 6. And for 7/3, we'll multiply by 2 over 2 to obtain a common denominator of 6. So now we have 21/6 divided by 14/6. So we want to determine how many 14/6 there are in 21/6, and because our denominator is the same, the quotient is just the quotient of the numerators. We would have 21 divided by 14. Well, 21 divided by 14 in fraction form is 21 over 14, but 14 and 21 do share a common factor of 7, so this does simplify. ¼ is equivalent to 3/2, which is a simplified fraction, but since this is an improper fraction, we could also express this as a mixed number. 3 divided by 2 would be 1, 2, and 3. 1 times 2 is 2, we subtract, remainder of 1. 3/2 is equivalent to 1 1/2, which means there is 1 1/2 14/6 in 21/6. We're going back to the original problem, there is 1 1/2, 2 1/3, and 3 1/2. So before we use our traditional method to find this quotient, let's take a look at a model that'll help explain what's actually happening here. Again, we just saw that 3 1/2 divided by 2 1/3 is equivalent to 21/6 divided by 14/6. So here the blue shaded region represents 3 1/2, or divided into 6, this would be 21/6. And our goal here is to determine how many 14/6 there are in 21/6. So if we count up 14 pieces, that would be 1 14/6. So notice here's 6 pieces, here's another 6 pieces, that's 12/16. So 2 more pieces would make up 1 14/6. So all of these pieces here represent 1 14/6. And notice how we have pieces left over. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pieces, or 7/16, which is actually half of 14/16. So the remaining pieces, these pieces here, represent the half that we found. So there are 1 1/2, 14/16 in 21/6, or 1 1/2, 2 1/3 in 3 1/2. Let's also show the traditional method for finding this quotient. Starting with 7/2 divided by 7/3, this is equivalent to the multiplication problem where we have 7/2 times the reciprocal of 7/3, which would be 3/7. So we can see the 7s would simplify to 1, leaving us with a product of 3/2, which of course is our quotient, which is also equal to 1 1/2. So as expected, regardless of the method that we use, the quotient is the same. So it's up for you to decide which method works best for you. I hope you found this explanation helpful.